Hi, boys and girls, and welcome to 5-Minute Bedtime Stories with Miss Elaine. Tonight, we're going to read a story called The Gruffalo by Julia Donaldson, and it's from my friend Marco. I have to thank Marco because he's the one who recommended this or requested it, and I had never heard this story before, and I loved it. I think you all will too. A mouse took a stroll through the deep, dark wood. A fox saw the mouse, and the mouse looked good. "Where are you going to, little brown mouse? Come and have lunch in my underground house." "It's terribly kind of you, Fox, but no, I'm going to have lunch with a Gruffalo."
"A Gruffalo, Mouse? What's a Gruffalo?"
"A Gruffalo, Fox? I'm surprised you don't know. He has terrible tusks and terrible claws and terrible teeth with terrible jaws."
"Where are you meeting him?"
"Here by these rocks. And his favorite food is roasted fox."
"Roasted what? Oh my," Fox said. "Goodbye, little mouse." And away he sped.
"Silly old fox. Doesn't he know? There's no such thing as a Gruffalo." Oh, that mouse was pretty smart. He outsmarted the fox. He made up that creature called a Gruffalo and scared the fox away. On went the mouse through the deep, dark wood. An owl saw the mouse, and the mouse looked good. "Where are you going to, little brown mouse? Join me for tea in my treetop house." "It's frightfully nice of you, owl, but no, I'm going to have tea with a Gruffalo."
"A Gruffalo, mouse? What's a Gruffalo?"
"A Gruffalo, owl? I'm surprised you don't know. He has knobbly knees and turned out toes and a poisonous wart at the end of his nose." "Where are you meeting him?" "Here by this stream, and his favorite food is owl ice cream."
"Owl ice cream, twit, twoo! Goodbye, little mouse."
And away owl flew. "Silly old owl, doesn't he know? There's no such thing as a Gruffalo." So he outsmarted the fox, and now he outsmarted the owl. That's a good thing, because he didn't want to be eaten. It's a good thing he's so smart. On went the mouse through the deep, dark wood. A snake saw the mouse, and the mouse looked good. "Where are you going to, little brown mouse? Come for a feast in my log pile house." "It's wonderfully good of you, snake, but no, I'm having a feast with a Gruffalo."
"A Gruffalo, mouse? What's a Gruffalo?"
"A Gruffalo, snake? I'm surprised you don't know. His eyes are orange, his tongue is black. Sharp purple prickles cover his back."
"Where are you meeting him?"
"Here by this lake, and his favorite food is scrambled snake."
"Scrambled snake, it's time I hid. Goodbye, little mouse."
And away snake slid. "Silly old snake, doesn't he know? There's no such thing as a Gruffa." "Oh, but what is this creature with terrible claws and terrible teeth and terrible jaws? Are those knobbly knees and turned out toes? Is that a poisonous wart at the end of his nose? Are those eyes orange? Is that tongue black? Do sharp purple prickles cover its back? Oh yes, oh no, a Gruffalo! Oh no, is there really such a thing? Oh dear, what's gonna happen to poor little mouse now?
"My favorite food," the Gruffalo said. "You'll taste good on a slice of bread."
"Good," said the mouse. "Don't call me good. I'm the scariest creature in this deep, dark wood. Just walk behind me and you'll soon see. Everyone for miles is afraid of me."
"Oh, sure," said the Gruffalo, bursting with laughter. "You lead the way and I'll follow after."
They hadn't walked far when the Gruffalo said,
"I hear a slither in the grass ahead."
"It's Snake," said Mouse. "Why, Snake, hello." Snake stared hard at the Gruffalo.
"Oh, shivers," hissed Snake. "Goodbye, little mouse."
And he slid right back into his log pile house. "You see," said Mouse, "I told you so."
"Hard to believe," said the Gruffalo.
They walked some more till the Gruffalo said,
"I hear hooting in the trees ahead."
"It's Owl," said Mouse. "Why, Owl, hello.
Owl stared hard at the Gruffalo. Boo-woo, screeched Owl. Goodbye, little mouse, and flew right up to his treetop house.
You see, said Mouse, I told you so.
Maybe you're right, said the Gruffalo.
They walked some more, so the Gruffalo said,
I hear paws on the path ahead.
It's Fox, said Mouse.
Why, Fox, hello. Fox stared hard at the Gruffalo.
Oh, help, barked Fox. Goodbye, little mouse.
And he scampered into his underground house.
Well, Gruffalo, said Mouse, don't you agree? Everyone in the wood is afraid of me. But now my tummy is beginning to rumble, and my favorite food is Gruffalo Crumble.
Gruffalo Crumble,
the Gruffalo said, and quick as the wind, he turned and fled.
Then all was quiet in the deep, dark wood. The mouse found a nut, and the nut tasted good.
The end. Wow, that mouse scared everyone away, even the big old Gruffalo. What did you think, boys and girls? I hope you enjoyed it. Thanks again to Marco for the recommendation. And now it's time for our two special lullabies. We're going to sing Twinkle, Twinkle, Little Star, followed by God Bless the Moon.
Twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wonder what you are. Up above the world so high, like a diamond in the sky. Twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wonder what you are.
And now God bless the moon. Ready?
I see the moon and the moon sees me. God bless the moon and God bless me.
And God bless all of you boys and girls at home. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you again real soon on 5-Minute Bedtime Stories with Missy Lane. Good night.